Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa tasleeman kathira thumma amma ba'd. Since tonight inshallah ta'ala, as we come closer and closer to the first night of the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, tonight will be the 21st obviously. What is a special dua that needs to be said during those very special nights? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, during the last 10 nights, he used to make special effort. As in Hadith Aishah radiallahu ta'ala anha, قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل عشر, when the last 10 nights start and begin, he صلى الله عليه وسلم أحيا ليله, he would stay up all night, وأيقظ أهله, and he would wake up his family to do the same as well. قال وجد وشد المئزر, and he would tighten his belt, which means he puts extra effort than what he did in the first 20 days of the month of Ramadan, or it means that he would not actually approach his spouse for pleasure, which means that's it, he would take a break. Now, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, one day she asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, since she have seen the Prophet put so much emphasis on the last 10 nights, obviously, and the chance to catch Laylatul Qadr and get the reward for Laylatul Qadr, she said, قالت يا رسول الله, أرأيت إن علمت أي ليلة ليلة القدر ما أقول فيها. She said, يا رسول الله, if I'd know which night will be Laylatul Qadr, what should I be saying on that night? Like, what is the best dua that you recommend for me to say in the night of Al-Qadr? And that's what we're going to study together, inshallah ta'ala. The hadith is number 1195 in Riyad al-Saliheen. قالت قلت يا رسول الله أرأيت إن علمت أي ليلة ليلة القدر ما أقول فيها. She said, O Messenger of Allah, if I realize ليلة القدر, what should I appreciate in it? What should I say? قال قولي, then you should say, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. He said, supplicate the following, say, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. O Allah, you are most forgiving, and you love forgiveness, so forgive me. حديث رواه الترمذي. And as simple as it sounds, but the message that is in there is extremely profound. When you say, اللهم إنك عفو, as you know that when the adab with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever you make dua, you don't write straight, you go straight into asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do you start with first? Thana, praise. So you praise Him, you acknowledge Him, you recognize Him by His beautiful names and attributes. And then also, like Sheikh Omar was talking about in the Khatirah earlier, whenever you want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something, it is highly recommended and more appropriate that you choose the right name of Allah for that. So if you're looking for rizq and provision, which name would you use for the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Al-Razzaq, Al-Kareem, Al-Jawad, the generous subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who provides. If you're looking for forgiveness, what do you ask? Which name do you use? Al-Ghafoor, Al-Rahim, Al-Tawwab, the one who accepts the tawbah, right? So you choose the appropriate names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here that we were asking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us, to give us amnesty. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, قال اللهم إنك عفو. Ya Allah, you are oft forgiving, عفو. And you love العفو, you تحب العفو, you love forgiveness. فعفو عني, therefore Ya Allah, forgive me. We learned, if you remember, one of the sessions that we had is in the adab of dua, is repeat, consistency, and insisting in your dua. So here you see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam repeated the word عفو three times. اللهم إنك عفو. تحب العفو فاعف عني, like saying عفو عفو عفو. That insistence shows what? So shows that how much in need you are to it. Because when you're in need of something, what do? You repeat that same thing over and over again. You're insisting on it. So here you're showing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how much in need you are of al-afu. But then what is al-afu? Even though the translation says forgiveness, but we explained that in the previous sessions before, if you guys remember, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He expresses and He gives afu and forgiveness in different ways. The first thing is forgiveness. The second thing is afu. The third thing is what? Safh, if you remember. So what is forgiveness? The literal translation of forgiving, or maghfira, ghafoor in the Arabic language, is concealment. That's the literal meaning of maghfira. To yaghfir, it means to cover, to conceal. So when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, This is more like saying, Ya Allah, conceal these sins from me. Cover them, please. Like, I know I can't remove them, because they happen, right? You can't just eradicate them in a way that just like they never happen, because they already happen. So all I'm asking is for Allah to cover them, conceal them, that I don't see them anymore, and no one else could see them. But in the extension of that meaning, it means what? Erase them and remove them from me. That's what it means. The second thing, al-afu, which is what we're asking here. Al-afu is different from al-maghfira, that when you seek forgiveness from somebody, you're only seeking that they don't seek punishment. Like you ask them to, you know, waive their right to punish you for what you've done. That doesn't mean they can't hold it in their heart. That's what forgiveness is. You forgive somebody, it doesn't mean you're going to remove it from the heart. You're still holding it in your heart, but you know what? I'm not going to punish you. That's called forgiveness. What's better than that's called afu. Because when you forgive, you remove it from the heart. That's called afu. Like, I remove it from the heart completely. I'm not holding grudge against you. But that doesn't mean I'm going to be lovey-dovey with you either. Like, I'll see you, I'll say salam to you, and that's it. I'll be very formal and very diplomatic with you. But then comes the third one, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called as-safh. As-safh is when you meet the person who wronged you, and you forgave them, and you did the afu to them. When they meet you and you meet them, they feel absolutely nothing in regards to what happened in the past. You know, because sometimes when you forgive people and they meet you, they feel awkward. They have that guilt tripping in their hearts because of what they've done to you. But when you meet them and you treat them like nothing ever happened and that you completely threw that behind your back, that's what as-safh is. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commands people, He says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, fasfah as-safh al-jameel. Make sure you're Muhammad to express with them as-safh, to give them that safh, that is most beautiful safh, most beautiful forgiveness. It's not just a matter of waiving the punishment. It's not a matter of not holding grudge. It's a matter of pretending that it never happened at all. Never, ever happened at all. That's what it means, really. So when we say, Allahumma innaka afuwwun, Ya Allah, you're afu. You love to forgive, and Ya Allah, you never hold it against me. Tuhibbul afwa, and I know that you love to forgive and never hold it against me. Fa'afu anni, Ya Allah, forgive me, and Ya Allah, remove it from my record like it never happened. That's what it means. So this is a dua that the Prophet ﷺ was recommending for us to say in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. So we're going to repeat that, inshallah, 3 times. So hopefully you can start using it from tonight and onward, bidnillahi azza wa jal. And hopefully, bidnillah, by the end of this series, when you start hearing the dua in the tahajjud and in the witr, at least you recognize those words and you know what do they mean to you, inshallah ta'ala. So let's repeat that dua together, inshallah. Allahumma, innaka, afuwwun, tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni. Allahumma, innaka, afuwwun, tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni. Allahumma, innaka, afuwwun, tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni. Allahumma inni أعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجذام وسيء الأسقام. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شر سمعي ومن شر بصري ومن شر لساني ومن شر قلبي ومن شر منيي. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من منكرات الأخلاق والأعمال والأهواء والأدواء. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من فتنة النار وعذاب النار ومن شر الغنى والفقر. اللهم لك أسلمت وبك آمنت وعليك توكلت وإليك أنبت وبك خاصمت وإليك حاكمت. فاغفر لي ما قدمت وما أخرت وما أسررت وما أعلنت أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر لا إله إلا أنت ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن والعجز والكسل والبخل والهرم وعذاب القبر اللهم آت نفسي تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم إني أعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعوة لا يستجاب لها اللهم إني أعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شر ما عملت ومن شر ما لم أعمل اللهم اغفر لي خطيئتي وجهلي وإسرافي في أمري وما أنت أعلم به مني اللهم اغفر لي جدي وهزلي وخطئي وعمدي وكل ذلك عندي اللهم اغفر لي ما قدمت وما أخرت وما أسررت وما أعلنت وما أنت أعلم به مني أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت فاغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن والعجز والكسل والجبن والهرم والبخل وأعوذ بك من عذاب القبر وأعوذ بك من فتنة المحيا والممات اللهم إني أسألك الهدى والسداد اللهم أصلح لي ديني الذي هو عصمة أمري وأصلح لي دنياي التي فيها معاشي وأصلح لي آخرتي التي فيها معادي واجعل الحياة زيادة لي في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لي من كل شر اللهم إني أعوذ بك من جهد البلاء ودرك الشقاء وسوء القضاء وشماتة الأعداء اللهم مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني واهدني وعافني وارزقني اللهم إني أسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم آمين جزاكم الله خير